your step with me this morning, so I will apologize in advance. And yes, of course, I'm nervous, as I always am. And could someone please put my name in the attendance sheet? Because I have no idea where one is up here. We will be collecting prayer cards, so please feel free to fill them out, because I will be more than happy. I'm doing the prayers today, the joys and concerns, so I will say them. And I do have a few announcements. That was one of them, that we'll be collecting cards. I just want to remind everyone about the online giving that we're going to be starting, and so you can go to our website or ask Deb Bennett about any other details about it. And I just want to remind everyone that 4th of July is around the corner. So if you're like thinking about the parade, make sure you get your application in to the town so that we can get everybody in the order. You want to make the parade a big hit. It's exciting. And then I need Sandy to come up. She has an announcement.
As you know, the UMW has been working on the quilt project, trying to find out all we can about the people who made the squares. We're pretty much done with the writing. We just have half a row to go in row 8. Today I brought with me what we've written for row 1. So if I call your family's name, if you could stop by after church at the background table and just look and see what we've written. We had to do a little bit of phone call and found out that we missed some children here and some information. I got some good stories other places. So if you have anything to share about your family, their work in the church, their work in the community, interesting stories about their life, we'd love to include that. And I have a material today for the families of Ruth Halbert, George Dilley, Marie Martin, the Reverend Louis Bosley, Herb Davis, Charlie Osborne, Marvin Donaldson, Early Caldwell, John Pearson, Herb Rich, Ken Miller, Butch Clemens and Sandy Rust, Dorothy Durant, George Wadsworth, and Tammy Roberts. So hopefully I'll see you after church.
And Doug Walker has an announcement.
At the top of my voice, because we're lack thereof this morning. I'd
like to thank a few people that you may not see on this Sunday morning.
How many of you have been to the website? Has anybody gone to our website and looked at it? Oh, cool. Okay. Take a chance. Thanks. Yeah, I know, actually. Take a chance and get there, and one of the things you're going to see is a videotape of the service. And there are some people that are back there on the Sunday that you don't see. They're videotaping the service so that it's able to be posted on the website. Stephanie Matthews has done it. Dana Darman, there's your hand, Dana. Anybody? And the main guy back there is Dave Santafano. They give a lot of their time and are here on Sunday mornings to do that. And I know with Pastor Ed for the 3 group, it has been a challenge. One of the things that you don't get to see that we get to see is the look on Dave's face the first Sunday that Ed took off and went back there and got a cup of coffee and came back down here. And Dave's looking at me going, like this. I don't know what I'm going to do now. We're going to follow him. So we really appreciate the efforts that those 3 give us to make sure that our church service is up on the website every week. So thank you very much. The other 2 people I'd like to thank are those on the soundboard. Isabel Reynolds has been subbing out for Jim. I don't see Isabel here today, but Isabel's been jumping in for Jim when he's not able to be here. But on almost every Sunday, Jim's first sitting back there at that table, manipulating dials and slides and all kinds of fun things. And he's also here every Thursday night for praise team practice so that he has some idea of how bad we sound and what he can do with it. Now, we jokingly call him the best one-legged deaf sound guy in the business, but the efforts that Jim gives us are greatly appreciated, especially by those of us in the praise team, as he sometimes is able to manipulate those of us that are not quite on pitch. On a given Sunday, you might not hear our voices near as much as before, and as he has said many times to us, I can always turn you off. So, Jim, thank you very much.
Amen.
through Jesus Christ, you revealed to us a power that has no parallel. May the eyes of our heart be enlightened to this power and all it has done in our lives. Pour out your spirit of power upon us, that we may proclaim your glory and your grace. Amen. Please be seated.
My strength when I am weak.
Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his acts of greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with the tambourine and dancing. Praise him with the strings and flute. Praise him with the clash of the cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has a breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Okay, first of all, remember that praise team is audience participation. So stand, please. Whether you're in a time of abundance or of suffering, a time when the sun is shining brightly in your lives, or whether there's darkness, Psalm 114 tells us the attitude to have. It says, blessed be the name of the Lord, now and forever. Join us.
Every blood. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
this day, token of our lives and our substance. Take these lives and these gifts and cause them to work in this world, which we promise.
Scripture reading, Ephesians 5:19-21. Speak to one another with the psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. Sing and make music in your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
feel your inner vocalist being revealed as we're doing some of this music this morning. You have several options. You can sit out there in the congregation and belt it out for the Lord to hear, which we all enjoy. You can come up and join this choir and this praise team. Imagine. And we got to exit some people.
But I'm sure Janice will agree with me when I say
any and all comers. We love having people up there.
And we love seeing for you guys. So, first of all, how many of you out here, out there, Jim, did that introduce me?
Use your teacher voice.
He muted me.
No, I did.
Hang on. Here we go.
Technology. How many of you out there still have those little noisemakers? Anybody? Okay. I just happen to want you to know that I really love singing praise music. Doug, wait, what do you think?
I love being praise team.
We're up there counting how many times the song sings praise. How many words are in the room that says praise? I have to say that evoking that everybody sing praise to the Lord brought back some really, thank you. That's good, thank you. That brought back some really cool memories. My mom said one time, you know, how come you're up here with this thing and doing all the stuff that we're doing? And I said, it's your fault. And she looked at me and she said, what do you mean it's my fault? I said, because when I was in eighth grade, you drugged me to the Fort Wayne Coliseum. How much is that? How many is that seat? 10,000? 8,000 at least? For a Bill Gaither trio concert. And I fell in love with everybody saying praise to the Lord, along with some of the rest of this music. So, part of this is having fun. Music Sunday gets to mean that we all get to have a little bit of fun up here. So, I want you to stand. We're going to have some fun with these old songs. Come on, stand up. You got a little bit left in you. We're at the tail end of the service. Okay? You're looking at your clocks going, what? Already? Amen. All right. I need to warn you, though, as we sing through it. First of all, on this song, those of you that have things that make beautiful noise to the Lord, feel free. And if your parents knock them out of your hand, that's up to them. I need to warn you, though, that sometimes singing this stuff, especially some of these old songs, has a side effect. It's called smiling. So have fun with it, okay?
Ready?
Oh,
Okay. So as the service draws to a close this morning, and you notice the title on there behind me, you need to think about why we're here and what we believe. This song has become very special to us, and in part because of what it says. So, I don't even want to say in part, it is because of what it says. So as we sing through this morning, let those words sink into you, and sing it outside so everybody else can hear it.
In the presence of Christ, we have gathered. In the grace of Christ we depart. May God clothe you with power on high. May God put this power to work in each of us.